teaching a learning of three arts in the teaching of living as a great gentleman in a civilized society, in a civilized manner. And that was start life as a whole, not just a Buddhist academic life, or a life of argument over religious scriptures or Vedanta or Vedantic philosophy. As a matter of fact, Indian philosophy is highly argumentative, controversial, and every single thought you talk about philosophy, you find in Indian philosophy. There are six systems of Indian philosophy, and all of them, if you read them together, are so diverse that every single thought in the world which is contradictory and self-contradicting, you find in Indian philosophy. You are the most sacred concept, you are the most mundane concept, you are the most silly concept, charvaki. In the silliest of the silly thoughts, you can see so. And you are the most sacred philosophies in Veda, particularly Veda and other four Vedas. Now, between these two huge extremities and polarities, you have every shade of thought in Indian philosophy. Now, that's the representation of life. And Gurukula used to train their disciples to live that wholesome life in a civilized manner. Now, and I remember my sister about Gurukula, Sainik School is a Gurukula, because their teachers and students live together. And that brings to my mind another very, very important point, because today the teachers live. When the students venerate their teachers, when the students respect their teachers, they worship them. That's the Indian system of culture. When we expect so much from the students that they should learn from us all the wonderful things of life, the values, the philosophy, the ways of life, and the honest living, we should also remember two three things. Number one, that student comes to you with a innocence. Now here we have, I was telling the principle that young boys who sang prayer are so young, the sixth standard. At that formative years, when they come there, for them, teacher is a model. And they watch everything a teacher does, a teacher says, the way he walks, the way he talks, the way he dresses, everything of the teacher, those boys watch. Whether you are a male teacher or a female teacher, you are not, you are a model for them. That model is learned in their manners, in their models, in their dress, in their etiquette, in their talk, in their walk. Therefore, the biggest point of the teacher is to present such lively, real, living models before the students, which they can verbally imitate in such a way, they will become wonderful citizens of this country. I therefore on this great important occasion say and call upon all my friends and teachers present yourself to be models for all these great learning and others to come. And that is the importance of the teachers later. And secondly, from the level of the